Well, today's the day. I got the charger.
Cruise 6.0. Lithium batteries. We're gonna hook all this stuff up.
I can't wait. It's gonna be amazing. This should go straight forward, and that should be straight forward, and it's not. So we have to do a little surgery.
These are solid state, if you couldn't tell by the name. These are more energy dense. They're lighter. I think they're 2/3 the weight of the comparable size lithium.
If you could tell how light these are, one-handed in an awkward position, that's crazy.
The Power 48 5000, which is by Torqeedo, is pretty short, but it's very boxy. It's kind of like this size. The Torqeedo one, it's a 48 volt, 5000 watt hour, and it weighs 36.5 kilograms. And the solid state ones are 62 pounds. So for 18 less pounds, instead of 5,000 watt hours, I have the 700 watt hours. So I get a little extra free power for less weight, and it fits in my bow locker. When I got back here to Clearwater, I had looked up upgrading the electric motor on the dinghy. That's a 1 kilowatt, goes almost nowhere. It's equal supposedly up to 3 horsepower. I don't even think it's that. I can go around 5 knots, but not into the wind, not against the current. So I told Electric Marina that, and we started going through all the options, and we landed on the Torqeedo between the 3.0 and the 6.0. My big thing was I wanted to be able to plane the dinghy just like a normal 10 or 15 horsepower gas engine should be able to do. Found out that I needed the Cruise 6.0, so I know for sure that this will work. It's equivalent to 10 horsepower. And actually Torqeedo was bought, I think, by Yamaha. I'll have to double check that. But that means I should be able to get service many, many places instead of where the other motor was from. All right, so we are going to wire these in parallel. There's a good reason we're doing that. You can either wire batteries in parallel or series. These are each 48 volt batteries. We want to keep them at 48 volts because that's what the motor runs at. If we hook these up in series, we would make it a 96 volt battery, and that would obviously hurt the motor. If we wired these in series, that would make one 60 amp hour battery at 96 volts. It would basically combine these two, and because they're pushing out 96 volts, they would remain at 60 amp hours, which is really what each one is holding. Instead, and it is very warm in here, instead we're keeping these at 48 volts, 60 amp hours each. So when we combine these in parallel, we all of a sudden get one battery that's still 48 volts, but it's 120 amp hours. So it's twice as big. We're gonna go black to black. That's gonna run there. Red to red's here. And I could put this red to this red that connects to that red, and this black to that black to that black. That is parallel. Now, here's the bad thing about that. If it happened like this, all this battery's electricity has to go through this battery to get to here. And that just makes things unequal. So what we're gonna do instead is black's gonna stay here, red's gonna come over to this battery. So they're still in parallel, and this is hooked up to black and red, so it's all still gonna work, but the electricity is going to equally come through both of the batteries at the same time, or charge both batteries at the same time. All right. There we go. Now it's in lithium ion mode. I just heard it click. Hey, there we go. So that washer goes on there. Propeller goes on. Anode. Ooh, do you think this is still 17 millimeter? Oh, it is. Oh, thank you. That's just good job, engineers. Getting late. I think I'm gonna relax. So we'll catch you tomorrow, and hopefully. Oh, now we're crooked. Hopefully tomorrow we get to go fast. Guess what? The light turned green. Yeah, buddy. Okay, so I sat and I looked at some other dinghies
thought through it. So I am gonna switch out my dinghy at some point. But what I think I'm gonna do is go to the backup plan and put the batteries directly under this bench. And they're a little wider, obviously, than this bench, so they'll offset a little bit. But there's room for me to strap them down that way. It'll be much better. I can use the bow locker still. I don't know. I can't think of any other way around it right now. And then just some half hitches loose. There wasn't really any other directions. All right, we're gonna do a self-test. Propeller's free to move. And that is actually not straight. I don't like that at all. This should go straight forward, and that should be straight forward, and it's not. Well, that's a good sign. The display's powering up. I think it's time to put this away, and then we go for a speed test. That's 1,000 watts. I can't believe that other motor said it was putting out 1,000 watts. Electro Magrino was right. That motor didn't have the torque. Oh, hook and everything. That's 1,800 watts. Let's just see if we can get up on plane. Yes, we can. But it's also even more crooked now. That stopped our speed test, that's for sure. Look, I'm pointing straight ahead and we're turning like crazy. This beer was for celebration, but now it's for thinking. It is so crooked. This should have been easy. You probably shouldn't see the propeller pointing off to the side. So we have to do a little surgery. If you call Torqeedo, they'll make a case number and just send you a PDF. It's called Cruise 3.0, 6.0 Head Alignment V3. And there's a data cable. Yeah, so we won't be able to remove that. That's a hilarious. A pelican just dive bombed right next to the boat. Hear that click? That's when it hit. Probably around 18. Yeah, I think we're there. Okay. I hate being that unscientific. I mean, or at least that's as scientific as I could get with what I have at hand. That's the one I had to tighten up. It just scrunches down on it. That's the GPS receiver. Okay, you ready to go test this? Okay, it's time to go. So we're gonna step it up to, that's 2,000 watts at 4.5, and we're just really close to planing. So let's step it up a little bit. That's 3,000 watts. 4,400 watts. And we're planing. And I will say, it's shaft and everything in there is really nice and tight. Like, it feels good holding it. It doesn't feel weak or anything. That's 5,500 watts, 13.5 knots. It's fast. Thank you, Electric Marina. You guys helped me find exactly the right motor for what I wanted, helped me identify the right batteries. And once we found them, we even verified with those manufacturers that it was going to support and do exactly what we need. And I mean, thank you, Solid State Marine. I know there's so many thank yous here, but Solid State Marine, you made a good product. I thought it was going to be a long time before we saw Solid State batteries. And all of a sudden, they're here and I'm using them on a little dinghy. It's not even a big expensive boat or anything. Oh, it's a bit more expensive dinghy than it was before. And soon I'll have an even bigger dinghy, or nicer dinghy, so the batteries can go in the bow locker the way they should. Oh yeah, and thanks for watching. Please don't forget to like and subscribe. And there's also a little alarm bell button below the video. If you hit that, then it will actually let you know when I post another video. And that's especially for my sister, because she keeps saying she doesn't know when I post them. And my cousin, because he's new to YouTube. All right, thanks, love you guys.
The birds have been really active today. They're all over the place. You see the one just sitting on the sugar scoop? It's awesome when they're facing that way, because then they poop on the boat. I like when they land on the bow. If they land on the bow and face inward, then they poop off the boat. I don't mind that. And they always do that little tail waggle. It's so cool.